Irish Fest Milwaukee 2016. And with me is Moya Brennan. We filmed her last night in her show, and we'll have that on later. But Moya was gracious enough to give us a few moments of her time. So, Moya, welcome to Milwaukee.
Just brilliant to be here at Milwaukee Festival. It's fantastic. The music is just unbelievable. I'm enjoying playing here. I'm doing a lot of concerts, one of my own, but then a lot with the DeBarra family. Cormac and I have played a lot together, but it's with his brothers Finan and Donal and Eamon and Manus, and it's just great fun, really great fun. This old man had kind of a... He was quite ancient, when you call him the burnt out old man, very ancient. And he had money and land and livestock and the likes. And the pretty girl from the village thought she'd be doing well by marrying him, thinking he wasn't going to last very long. But this wasn't the case. So hence, in this song, in each verse, it describes how she tries to get rid of him.
Romantic.
Yes. Said, topical. Yeah.
Happy days. Anyway, in the first verse, it's about giving him too much to eat, and that was nothing happened. And then give him a lot to drink, and he was a very happy man. Then she took the food away and tries to starve him. That didn't work either. Nothing was working, really. She then decided to take him on a very long walk, and in the song, she describes it as...
1,020.
Yeah. A lot of mountains. He was really trying to make him go away. But nothing happened. He was very, 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 very tired afterwards, but and he lost all his hair and his teeth, but he was fine. So then she thought, okay, how will I get... you know, rid of this guy. So she thought, maybe by shocking him. So she went to the market and bought a coffin. Now, I don't know many markets that sell coffins, but obviously,
that's not real.
An old Irish tradition or something. But anyway, she brought the coffin home, and she found him dancing in the bedroom, waiting for her. Hello. Anyway, and the sad thing about this song, if there is a sad thing, is there's a version of this song in every county in Ireland, in nearly every county. So that's saying a lot.
It's an ancient Irish tradition, obviously.
I'm trying to kill your husband.
Thank you.
the fork, a kind of a look as quick at a fork, a swatch of a big or a jail of a
sort of hammering a water.
Sora hammering a water, sora hammering a water,
brother and juggling is finding a force.
Push your homini, a can at the core, a call you like a look as goody, a gun a happy, you know what to do, chop the fun,
all the fun, and the hammering at us, the chandra.
Sora hamanya hamanya hoche, sora hamanya hamanya hoche, brother and jumping is finding a posse.
Sora hamanya hamanya hoche,
sora hamanya hamanya hoche, sora hamanya hamanya hoche, brother and jumping is finding a posse.
Thank you.
Maya Brennan.
So this is it. We're showing it soon.
You come from a musical family, an extended musical family. Can you tell us something about how you first got started in music, Irish music?
Well, I suppose the Irish music that Clanna did really was to do with the Gaelic songs, because we come from Donegal and that was our very first language and still is my first language. So the songs were very, very important to me, and the instrumentation that Clanna had. And, you know, you're talking about sort of the early 60s. There weren't cultus schools around for you to learn traditional instruments. They were kind of, unless you, you know, had an uncle or an aunt or your mum or dad played, you would only, you know, I don't think you'd be able to play it very well without a proper teacher. So we ended up playing, you know, my father had a show band. So it was kind of the instrumentations of, you know, the guitar and the double bass and percussion and things like that. They sent me to a school to learn the harp, so I brought the harp into it. But mainly we concentrated on vocals. We loved harmonies, and because we were a family as well, my two brothers, my twin uncles and myself, that was the original five members of Clannad, and we did our first album in 73. And since then we have 18 albums now. The last one was released about 2 years ago, Nedur, which means the nature. And it's been, you know, it's been a great 45 years of music with Clannad, with my own stuff, and just with all the other sort of stuff that I've done throughout the years with different other musicians and singers and that. But I'm the eldest of nine, and my father really, and my mother, my father had played music all his life. My mother's a music teacher, so it was inevitable in our house. And my father opened a pub where we come from in Donegal, Leo's Tavern, in the late 1969. And, you know, that was really what kind of, I suppose, started Clannad, because it was a stage for us when we come home from school and or college or wherever we're at. And that was great fun. And so that's kind of how we started to play together. It was kind of very relaxed into it.
Well, it sounds like you've had a great time, and you also did some movies, I believe. You did the work on Titanic.
Well, I worked on the second soundtrack of Titanic. They wanted a voice like mine to sing "Come Josephine," so I ended up doing that.
Up a little bit higher.
Clannad have done music for Patriot Games, and we did music for The Last of the Mohicans.
on, lad. It's me, Charlie.
I did a song called You're the One for Circle of Friends.
You fill my sleep, you fill my heart with love, you make my life complete.
And then I wrote, I was writing with Hans Zimmer on the movie King Arthur. So, and there's a lot of TV stuff that we've done as well. 26 episodes of Robin of Sherwood with Clanna did way back in the 80s. So, yeah, very much involved in kind of movies and TV and pictures as such, so.
Anything in the works right now?
Well, I've been doing a lot of work in the studio. Actually, myself and my daughter have been doing writing music for this animation that's coming out in Australia, but it's going to be going around the world by the end of the year. It's called Prisoner Zero, and we're doing a lot of music in the 26 episodes, and we're going to be doing another 26 episodes next year. So that's been really fun and great. But I'm doing also another studio album, which is, you know, has been in the makings for a long time. And I'm hoping that myself and Cormac will also do another Voices and Harps album. So plenty to do.
Well, thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us, Moya. And we hope that we see you again soon. And we hope we hear a lot more from you in the future.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much for having me. And see you again sometime. Bye.
Fest 2016, Milwaukee Irish Fest, that is. And we're talking with Sean O'Connor. He's with the Casual Denahy Dancers. And you guys are from Milwaukee, I believe.
Yes, we've been around since 1983. Dennis Denahy came up from Chicago and started teaching dance in Milwaukee. And we've been a school here teaching Irish dance and growing the Casual family ever since.
So how many students have you in the school at the moment?
Anywhere from 160 to 200 students at a given time. We have three locations, Kenosha, Milwaukee, and Madison. So among those locations, anywhere from 160 to 200 dancers.
Now, how many competitions do you engage in per year?
Irish dancers compete in what's called feshes, and it's really up to them the number that they would like to compete in. But there's two major ones per year, or I should say three. That's the Aractus, the Nationals, and then Worlds.
And when are you going to be in Ireland again?
The World competition is actually in Belfast this year, so it will depend on how the girls do at this upcoming Aractus in Chicago over Thanksgiving weekend.
I hear that some of the schools are thinking of going away from the wigs and the fancy costumes. Are you trending in that direction or not?
We're actually just trending wherever competition leads, and currently right now wigs are predominant, as are the dresses, especially at the championship level. We certainly follow the rules for the younger children with no bling, no makeup, things along those lines, pretty much it.
All right, Sean O'Connor, thank you very much. We'll be looking forward to seeing you in the weeks ahead, and we've got some film of your guys and gals out there today. Thanks a lot.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
If you have a comment, suggestion, or question about today's Irish Journal TV, give us a call at area code 708-366-4665 or drop us an email at irishtv@ameritech.net. Call or email today because we look forward to hearing from you.
Now you can watch Irish Journal Television online. Simply browse to our website, irishtv.us, and watch shows like this one anytime you choose. We have now made Irish entertainment available to you 24/7. Don't miss in-depth articles and other new features we're sure you'll enjoy. Watch us anytime. Remember, it's irishtv.us.
Thank you.